Life is the art of drawing sufficient conclusions from insufficient premises. As rightly quoted by Samuel Butler, this lockdown period during the pandemic has taught us to achieve sufficient answers to our ever-questioning mind. This pandemic of 2020 has been the most unexpected crisis across the globe with the rapid spread of COVID-19. Though it's been 4 months since this lockdown, we have not gotten used to the idea of the growth of this virus or being in quarantine. Man kept running from pillar to post in search of luxury and finally ended up losing the greatest treasure of love from family. What would a man gain by toiling all day long when he has no family to share his earnings and happiness with? This pandemic period brought an end to all the yearnings for love and also brought about a drastic change in the environmental phenomenon. Nirmala College for Women, Department of English Aided, is proud to present this short film which shows what we've been through and leads to a future we all dream of.
Collection of books you have, Grandma. Let me take a look at it.
Well, that's because you never come to my room, darling.
An autobiography. Grandma, I never knew you wrote an autobiography.
Well, dear, that's because you rarely ever come to my room.
Maybe. I don't know. I think your room's a bit full with all these writings on the walls, bookshelves, and framed photographs of random people hanging here and there.
Nothing is random in my room, dear. Everything serves a purpose.
Grandma, understand the reason behind having Shakespeare's photo here. You are a literature student and now a writer. But I don't see the point in having Newton's photo here, Grandma.
Shakespeare and Newton inspired me to keep going on, even in times when everyone had lost all hope.
Oh, which was that year?
Do you really want to know?
Yes, read it to me, Grandma.
Well, Devi, thank you, but I don't need to refer to the book. I wrote it myself. The year was 2020. I was in college and all of our lives had come to a sudden standstill because of the coronavirus.
Coronavirus! Coronavirus!
commonly known as Corona, is threatening not only India, but the entire world. The death toll reaches 40,000. To fight this dreadful pandemic, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi declares a nationwide lockdown for 21 days from midnight tonight.
Before the corona catches me, catch the bus. Oh, I'm so bored.
Okay, let me start a video call and chat with my friends.
Hello.
Hey, buddies.
It's lockdown. Okay, guys. Jokes apart. The situation here is getting worse day by day.
That's true, Anne. You know, initially it was fine, but lockdown has cut short our pockets.
Yeah, it's really a hard time for us girls. Also, lockdown has done a lot of positive things. Do you agree with it?
Oh, yes. Did you guys watch the news on television? The world is healing. Great, na? The wildlife is getting back to its places and the natural bodies are cleaning themselves.
This is the right time to think about others.
Exactly, guys.
Sneha?
Yeah, Mom?
Come, cut the onions.
Okay, guys. Mom's calling. You know, I have started cooking.
Really?
Sneha, gonna cook? Go ahead, man. We'll catch up later.
Bye.
Hi, Sneha. How are you? So, today we're going to make carrot halwa, and the basic ingredients that is needed is, in a pan, take 2 tablespoons of ghee, to it add raisins and cashew nuts and allow it to get nicely brown. After it is brown, to it add grated carrots and milk and allow it to nicely cook.
Wow, that is what I call fun, Grandma.
Well, I'm sure you would have, dear. Many surely did. But unfortunately, that was not the case for everyone. For many, it was a dream come true, but for most, it was a terrifying nightmare.
Good evening, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Unfortunately, we will have to face this financial crisis alone. We can survive like this for a month, but I don't know what we'll do after that.
Hello, Anne. How are you? Happy birthday to you in advance.
Hey, Joseph. Thank you so much.
I'm so helpless, Anne. I can't do anything to please you. This this lockdown gets over.
That's all right.
This lockdown is just stifling. I wanna get out.
What? Don't you ever think about getting out? Haven't you seen those videos where the policemen are punishing the guys who went out unnecessarily?
What are you talking about, Anne? I really haven't seen those videos. Could you just send me them now?
Lochak, mochak, bachak, lochak, mochak, bachak, lochak.
That's the best reward. Oops! Even I should be staying at home, right?
So-called quarantine birthday.
So how are you, Anne? How's your life? By the way, how is Corona?
Corona is happy. It's just me who isn't.
Why? What happened?
I mean, look at me. Cutting the cake and having it all alone. No party, no friends. What a waste.
Anne, don't worry. Be happy. At least you're safe over there. Look at me. My grandmother is being quarantined. And they have taken her to a different place. This really makes me feel worried. I'm all alone in my house and have to take care of everything. I'm so worried. The situation here is getting worse day by day. Have you been following the death rates?
Severe over there?
Yes, the curve is never going to flatten this way. I feel so disheartened. All I hear about is death, death, death.
Don't worry. Everything will be fine.
Where is my destination? Where is my future? How long am I gonna be enclosed in these four walls? I see darkness everywhere. Can anything be done about this?
What are you doing, Daddy?
Daddy is applying for an e-pass here so that Daddy can travel to our shop to take care of things there.
But you never took a pass before. Why now?
Our country is in complete lockdown here. We cannot roam out unnecessarily. Even if it is necessary, like Daddy traveling to our shop, we have to get an e-pass from the government.
Can you take a pass to go to the park, Daddy?
No, dear. All the parks, malls, cinema theatres and game centres are closed now. We cannot go there and we won't get pass for going there too. Remember, I said avoid unnecessary travel.
Okay, Daddy.
Thank you.
wrong with him? Why he's not coming out of his room?
Sweetie, your dad is not feeling well, so he's distancing himself from all of us.
But why, mommy? Can I go and see him?
No, dear, you can't. He has distanced himself so that we won't get the infection from him.
Will he be alright, mommy?
For sure, darling. I'll inform the concern people by dialing the toll-free number. They'll be here any moment and they'll check up on your daddy. Okay?
I hope he will get better soon.
Of course, dear. Pray for him.
Oh my God. How did you overcome all of this then, Grandma? Everything seems to be like a nightmare to me.
Well, it certainly was, dear. But it was more of a lesson that Mother Nature taught us to show us that the world didn't belong to us. We had no right over it. And we saw that without us, the outside world flourished. But first, of course, we had to get rid of the virus before it caused too much damage.
Yes! This time of quarantine was hard. Yes, we had to fight a virus stronger than us. Yes, we had to let go of a few dear ones who were weak. Yes, we struggled to earn a living. But we are survivors. We survived this pandemic. We missed a few, but we loved the ones near us a lot more. We equipped ourselves to live at any hard circumstance, and above all, we learned to live each day with love, faith, and courage that brought us back another chance to live today better. Is proud to have fought the virus successfully, and the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has confirmed the country free of COVID-19. The country will slowly get back to its run with the functioning of schools, colleges, and universities.
After the pandemic ended. If Shakespeare and Newton could live through such tough times as the bubonic plague, what was my excuse? The plague killed off most of Europe in the Middle Ages. Shakespeare wrote most of his plays at the time, which earned him the title of the greatest dramatist of all time. And Newton discovered the law of gravity, which laid foundation for later sciences to develop. If they could do so much from nothing, what was my excuse? Time is everything, darling.
That's great and amazing.
Grandma, I'll be right back.
In the time of a pandemic is a hard feeling to hold on to. But let's continue holding on to it to live a better tomorrow by living the best with what we have today. Every day is an opportunity for us to realize the value of what we have and to cherish them. Let us live the moment to make this pandemic a memory than a nightmare.
'Cause we are warriors, we'll fight for our lives like soldiers.